Conservation this week, and there's been a lot of activity around the electorate encouraging people to get out, get interested in conservation, plant some trees, add to their knowledge, and maybe look after their at-risk pets with the Kiwi aversion training for dogs at Gordon Park on Saturday morning. There's also been another initiative in that there's been a donation from the Roberts Thompson Trust of some beautiful big books identifying native trees. A number have been donated for intermediate schools and high schools around the electorate, and I'm going to be dropping them off in the next week or so as the Parliament is in recess next week, so I'll be able to spend some time in the electorate. Some annoying news that has come in the last couple of weeks with the proposed disestablishment of 14 dock positions from the Whanganui Dock Office for redistribution to service centres around the country, and to move with the conservation headquarters to Taupo in the next few months. The people in these positions haven't been identified yet as to who will get the job, but the positions have been identified as to which ones will either be disestablished, moved to the service centre, or moved to the conservancy headquarters in Taupo. It's really frustrating that positions would be taken away after only less than 12 months ago the decision was made to leave things as they were, so I find that very frustrating, and I'm continuing to fight hard discussing this with the Minister, with the CEO of Conservation, and to arrange a meeting with Mayor Annette Main and the Conservation Minister as soon as we can do that. There was a very volatile public meeting in Whanganui yesterday, Wednesday afternoon, in which members of the audience called for my resignation as an MP for Whanganui. I accept that as a Member of Parliament and as a politician, then I am confronted with the public's views, and they can say anything to me, anything at me, and I have to take it because that's the job. We have a very stringent performance appraisal that comes up every 3 years, and the next one is on the 26th of November this year. And so people will have the opportunity to vote me in or vote me out, and I live and fall by that sword, and that is that's the nature of the job, and I'm happy with that. So I'll be working as hard as I can to retain these positions. I may or may not be successful, but I want people to rest assured that I am working hard on that. Other issues that have come up at the moment is whether or not the H in Whanganui will be legislated for prior to this coming election, and the answer is it probably won't. The issue has been that the Minister, in allowing Whanganui with an H and Whanganui without an H to be used as alternates, is something that doesn't have precedent in our law. The Green Party wanted it to be a dual usage, which actually does have precedent. So they wouldn't allow leave for Parliament to make this change as part of a statutes amendment bill, which means we have to bring a new piece of legislation that hasn't been a priority for the government, and so that will happen next year, hopefully early in the term. Good news on another front, and that is the Cold Creek Water Scheme in South Taranaki. This is a scheme that was built and paid for by farmers and the taxpayers in collaboration with farmers, and there has been a move for several years now for South Taranaki District Council, or as it existed in previous under previous personalities, for instance the Waimate Plains District Council, to vest the ownership in this water scheme back with the farmers who operate it, who are the consumers of the water, who apply for the licences and do all the repairs and maintenance. And so this needs to take the form of a local bill. At the moment that's going through the notification processes. So hopefully we'll be able to table and introduce that bill before the House rises on the 6th of October. If not, we'll be able to do it before the House is prorogued, in other words, all parliamentary business stops on the 20th of October. So this week has been a fairly busy week with the meetings as I've outlined previously. Also, we had a big grey power meeting in Whanganui yesterday afternoon. There was about 120 people present, and all the candidates were present. There were questions from the floor and questions from the chair, and it was a good meeting. The second of the Meet the Candidate meetings will be run over this campaign. tomorrow, Friday, I have the regional chiefs meeting in Martin. I'm hoping to do some activities around schools and the delivery of the books that I mentioned earlier tomorrow, and attend a Federated Farmers meeting in the afternoon before going to some arts meetings to do with the some art exhibitions to do with the real Whanganui Arts Festival. Saturday we have the Minister of Arts, Culture and Heritage, the Honourable Chris Finlayson, in the electorate, and he's going to be celebrating the real arts festival, attending River City Market, going to the museum, going to the art gallery, meeting with the Historic Places Trust, opening the big paint and opening the glass exhibition in the evening. And then next week, as I said, it was a recess, so I'm going to be actively campaigning in the electorate, and on Tuesday I'll be assisting the Honourable Kate Wilkinson in her electorate in Waimakariri. But expect me to be knocking on your door soon if you live within the Whanganui electorate, because we're in campaign mode and full on. Thank you very much.